Well, folks, I thought it was time for a little update on the Land Rover. It's had a bit of work done since you last saw it, since all the brake and axle work was done. I've gone through the cooling system, replaced a few exhaust sections, manifold gaskets, that kind of thing, and it's just running a bit better for it. Most obvious thing, of course, is that it's got a winch on the front now. So let's have a look at that first. So WRD's now got a Fury capstan winch fitted. I fitted it yesterday and it was quite a mission actually. I found that it wouldn't actually fit without just notching the bumper slightly. I guess we're up against their replacement aftermarket chassis. The mounting plate for the winch is also aftermarket, and I suspect the bumper might have been replaced at some time too. But I got it to fit. It looks the part, it works. I'll take some better film with it with a light later on. But basically, if you haven't seen one of these before, it's driven from the crank pulley on the front of the engine. The work to the brakes, hubs, axles, all seems to be holding up just fine. No oil leaks, nothing untoward so far. Stopping very much better. Pulls up straight and true every time, which is what was not happening before. But the main changes have happened under the bonnet, so let's have a look there. So some years ago, when I first had the vehicle, I fitted a plastic radiator, replacing the leaking original. Or a plastic tank radiator, I should say, aluminium core. I've now got a proper brass one, which Britpart make. Actually quite a good quality, I thought. That fitted without any holes being drilled out or anything like that. It just fitted, which was nice. So all the coolant hoses have been replaced. I rebuilt a water pump myself. I've never done one of those actually, and that appears to be fine. New thermostat housing, new fuel pipe. I had the manifolds off and replaced the manifold gasket. I've used one of the HNJ Engineering graphited gaskets, and that seems to be very good. All proper fixings for the manifold now. I replaced the downpipe and the midsection of the exhaust. I also see that I've added a takeoff for the gauge on the dashboard, so the temperature gauge part of that combined gauge unit now reads. That's hot water coming direct out of the head to the heater, so it's about it, proper engine temperature. Not ideal, it should be in the block really, in the thermostat housing, but it's a very short term capillary on that. So you can see we've got a new heater valve. Basically all the heating and cooling system has been gone through. New heater matrix, as the old one was a bit dodgy. And the motor in the heater has been rebuilt. It runs about twice as fast as before. So all just a bit tidier under the bonnet. So you can see that gauge is now reading. I think the next thing to do is to clean up the dashboard. That really is a bit of a mess nowadays. So nice to have that. The engine actually holds a better temperature, sits at about 75-80 degrees while you're driving. It's an 82 degree thermostat, but yeah, it sits somewhere between there, and it's obviously warmer than what it was before. Inside we've now got some proper seatbelt bars. I've never had these. Really impressed with these ones. I got them on eBay. But they're really solidly made, and once bolted on, extremely sturdy. And I know that anything safety wise is a bit of a gesture with one of these vehicles, but it does bring the belt up to a proper height, and it does definitely work better, so I feel just a little bit better having those. Otherwise, not a lot's changed in here. Needs a good clean out. Well, there is one more thing. I'm going to spin the camera around for this. I have taken off the brackets behind the driver's seat so that it leans back a bit. In fact, the seat backs are new as well because they've broken. So you can see I've lost those brackets and the seat actually sits a bit further back, a little bit more comfortable for me to drive. Hopefully you can see no oil leaks from the axle as yet, all good. Really busy out today. The manifold gasket was definitely leaking. She's running quite a bit sweeter now. In fact, I had to retune the carburetor as it was running quite rich. That's obviously been an issue for some time. Anyway, there's the winch working. I've yet to actually try it in anger, but hopefully we'll put that right very soon. There you go, so not a lot more to report really. Very much better for all the improvements. The long range fuel tank seems to work fine. Unfortunately, there's a slight leak from the sender, so I've got to run it down a bit and then drop the tank out again and change the washers I used on the screws for the sender. That's all it is, but this results in a slight petrol smell in the cabin. Otherwise, a few long distance trips to steam rallies to go to, and then hopefully at the end of July, I'm taking it to Brittany. I'm cheating a bit, going on the overnight ferry, arriving at St Malo, but should be a little bit of an adventure, kind of a build up to the big trip next year. So I just wanted to show you that winch really, but the Land Rover is going along well, and I'll be sure to take some film when I try the winch. Thanks for watching.